So today we are going to start with the two questions that were left for Adventures of Toto. Okay, so Diya, speak out the first question that was left.
How does Toto take a bath? Where has he learned to do this? How does Toto almost boil himself alive?
Yes. So one day a kettle was being kept on the fire. For boiling water, or that could serve the purpose of tea. Okay, but Toto thought that it was just place for him to take bath. So what did Toto? He touched the temperature with his finger, and he, because of extreme cold, what he did that he jumped into the hot water kettle. Okay, the kettle containing the hot water, and inside the kettle, what happened that earlier, Toto was feeling quite well, quite satisfied and quite relaxed because it was very cold outside. But when the water started boiling, then it was difficult for Toto to sit in the kettle. Toto was again and again coming and jumping out of the kettle. He was trying to come out of the kettle, but outside, because of the cold weather, he was again sitting inside it. Soon the water started boiling, and what happened?
Almost
that
cold.
The grandmother,
she started.
The grandmother arrived at and pulled him out in half boiled condition.
Okay, from being boiled. And Toto has learned, you can say, the complete technique of taking bath. From where he has learned? He has learned it from that of the narrator, okay? Because he would check the temperature first of all. He would check the temperature with one of his finger. And then what he will do? And then ultimately he will put first of all one leg, then another leg, and he would sit into the water tub. And after sitting in the water tub, Toto would apply, you can say, the Toto would apply, you can say, soap
all over his
body. And this technique he has learned it from, you can say, from that of the narrator, okay? The narrator, as he is going to take bath. And moreover, during that time, if somebody would laugh at Toto, this would, you can say, ultimately hurt his feelings, and he would never take
bath. Him.
He would never go near the water, okay? So next, afterwards, the next question.
Why does the author say Toto was not the sort of pet we could keep for long?
Yes, the author said that Toto was not a sort of pet to be kept at home, because on the very first day when Toto was brought home, it has been stored or it has been kept in a wardrobe. Okay, it has been kept in an almirah, so in the closet. So where what it had done, it had taken off the peg that was attached to the wall. And ultimately, what he did, the coat of the narrator, it was torn into shreds. Okay, it was completely in shreds. And after that, what has happened? After that, he has taken off the ornamental paper that was decorating the walls. And this led to, looking off only the, or making the plaster as well as the bricks naked, right? So this is not the only case. So later on, what has happened? He has created too much, you can say, or immense disturbance to that of the other animals who were living in the private zoo of the grandfather. Okay, he has never developed good relationship with the donkey Nana, and moreover, he is never allowing to let sleep other animals in the stable. And after that day, when the pulao was cooked and what was placed on the dining table, what he has done, he has taken the entire tray and his hand. And he was, you can say, stuffing his mouth with that of rice. And upon, you can say, when the aunt came and shouted at the monkey, in order to irritate aunt, what he did, he jumped on the jackfruit tree and he was stuffing his mouth, and he has eaten every grain of the rice and leaving all the family without any lunch during that day. And after that, when grandmother came and she was shouting and screaming at Toto, what he did, he has thrown the plate onto the ground and was clapping when it was broken into pieces. So the grandfather and other family members, they thought that this kind of loss they could not afford, as they don't have so much of spare money to fulfill these kind of losses each and every day. So what happened ultimately? So finally, Toto was returned to the Tonga driver for a sum of rupees 3, and they thought that Toto is not a sort of pet that is to be kept at home. So, right, this answer clear, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I think with these, all the questions are complete.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now let us go to inquiry letters, which are to your fair notebooks. You can write down in fair notebooks. कि वी आर गोइंग टू डू लेटर ऑफ इंक्वायरी. Letter of inquiry. So what is an inquiry? What is letter of inquiry? Letter of inquiry is a letter written to the head of the institutions, okay, for some, you can say, official purpose. Suppose when you ask about the prices of something, when you ask about the catalog, about the various kind of models available, so different kind of inquiries you made. When you have to make an inquiry, for that an inquiry letter is written, okay. So now, because it is a, you can say, formal type of letter writing, okay, it is categorized into a formal type. So languages, you should be very particular about the language, okay. Talk to the point, ask what you want to ask, and just, you can say, write down what is to be asked by you, okay. Suppose today we are writing or doing a letter of inquiry for any short term course. You want to ask or you want to inquire for any course, short-term course, okay? So how you will ask, okay? Different categories are there, right? So you will do accordingly, right? Okay? Yes. So let us, students are still entering. See what is the time. I don't know why they are late. Yes. So now, first of all, what you will write down? You will write down sender's address. Sender's address will be written, okay. So sender's address, suppose it is given, okay. If it is given, then it's fine, okay. If not, you can write down examination or dash city, okay. Then leave line, write down date. You know what is the right way of writing a date, that how you will write a date. You will write a date, for example, today is 5th May 2021, okay. If you are writing it the date 5/5/2021, this is wrong. Okay. This is considered to be wrong. So you will not write the date in this manner. Okay. Then afterwards, you will leave line to whom you are writing. The head. Okay. The head of that institution you are writing. Suppose let it be director. Okay. So the director. Right. Suppose you are going to ask for any course, okay, dash name of the, you can say, institution, okay, from which you are going to ask, and then you will write down city. So three lines of, this is receiver's address, okay, and in three lines you will write down sender's address. It should be in three lines, okay. So in three lines each you will write down, okay, then salutation, sir, you can leave line here. Then subject, what is the subject here? What you want to ask, because it is an inquiry, you will mention to inquire about short term or to inquire about, and then you will put, write down accordingly what is required to you, okay. You will write down what is required accordingly. Okay. So, next afterwards, now coming up to body of the letter. So, what you will write down in body of the letter. Okay. Body of the letter. So, first paragraph, you just remember that is the introductory para. I always say, make in this manner. Introductory para. Okay. Which is para 1. Okay. So, here you will introduce. Okay, introduce, okay, and means you will just ask why you are writing. So for that, how you will write down, for example, suppose you have seen, how you come to know about that course, okay, you must have seen an advertisement in the newspaper, right? It is just because of this reason that you are going to ask for this course. Because suppose you are free for 2 to 3 months, okay? Like in this manner, you can write down, for example. Okay? So, how you will write down? Suppose, for example, referring to the advertisement, suppose in the Tribune dated so and so, okay? About the course mentioned by you, okay? About the course mentioned by you, I want to inquire about certain details, right? So then you will mention what you have done earlier, okay? okay, what you have done earlier and why you are going to do it. Okay, suppose I have passed, I have just appeared in class 10 board examinations, and I have 2 to 3 months at my disposal. 2 to 3 months at my disposal. Like, what is the reason why you are saying? You will mention the reason also, okay, that why you are going to do this course, right? And I have 2 to 3 months at my disposal, or I'm free during my summer vacations. So I want to pursue, or I want to continue, or I want to start a short-term course. Okay, any short-term course you can write down. It can be in a language, or it can be in case of, you can say, that of computer. Okay, any computer programming, computer designing, any short-term course. Okay, and suppose I have 2 to 3 months at my disposal, or you can say that I am free during, or I'm free during my summer vacation. Okay, then, right? But before pursuing or before starting this course, I would like to know about certain specified or certain or specified details. Okay, I would like to know about certain details. So now, okay, so this is our para one, in which you have mentioned that you are going to ask about what you are going to ask, what you are going to ask, and why you are going to pursue this course. You have mentioned the reason here. Okay, so next, afterwards, you will write down after that, coming up to para two. Okay, para two means that is the main para, which is the main para. Here you will ask about details. Ask about details. Okay, now give me some suggestions that in case of course, what you will ask? What you will ask?
Accommodation fees.
Okay, you will also ask about duration of course. Duration of course. Okay, mode of payment. Okay, or mode of payment of fee. Right? Then, whether it is a diploma or certificate, what it is. Okay, diploma or certificate. Any other idea?
Ma'am, question about faculty.
Faculty, yes, you can ask about faculty. Timings. Timings. Okay, then student-teacher ratio, or number of students, number of batches, okay? Number of batches and number of students in a batch.
Ma'am, opportunity is after completion of course.
What? Speak again.
Ma'am, opportunities after completion of course.
No, that you won't ask in that. Course. Okay? That you should aim.
Ma'am, opportunities after completion of.
Okay, so now in the light of these points, we will make out lines. Don't write down in by putting commas, okay? This is just for your reference. You will write down complete lines by forming a paragraph. For example, you can write down, I would like to inquire about the duration of the course, okay? And the fees to be paid. And whether the fees to be paid in installments or in lump sum, means in one go lump sum, or it is going to be paid in installments, or whether it is going to be paid in installments, right? And also let me know, every time you start a line, give a new start, okay? Also let me know about let me know whether this is a diploma or a certificate course, okay? And about the faculty too, okay? I would also be happy to know about the timings, okay? And the total number of batches available, okay? And are there special batches available for evening classes if you want, okay? If you want, you can also write that. And the number of students in a batch, right? You have asked about all, okay? So these are the details that you want to ask, right? So I'm rubbing it from here. okay, from the starting in order to utilize this space. Yes. Next afterwards, what we will do, next afterwards, we will write down in para 3. Okay, that is para 3. Now what para 3, which is a concluding one. Concluding, now you will conclude. Okay, concluding para. Okay, now you will conclude your letter. What you will write down? Yes, you will definitely say that provide me all the details at the earliest. Okay, you will ask about that all the details should be provided at the earliest. So in this case, how you will write down? You will also ask if you have any printed material, you can send it to me. Okay, you can send me a brochure, suppose it is, or anything else, prospectus. So in that case, it's not applicable. Okay, otherwise, you can say the institutions that you can say which are at higher level, they used to have the prospectus. You have to pay the fee for the prospectus and ultimately they will send it to you. So in this manner, you can also write down. Okay, suppose in case you have any printed material, okay, for information, kindly send it to me. If you have any printed material, then you can send it to me. Okay, if you have any, suppose you want to write down, if you have any printed material, for what? What? For what purpose? That is for information. That is for information, then you can send it to me. Okay. Now, why they will send you? Okay. You must have sent an envelope in that. Okay. So you can say a self-addressed and duly stamped. Okay. A self-addressed means you have already given a self-addressed and duly stamped means you have given the stamp also, because it will also, it must be stamped one. Duly stamped envelope is enclosed, or you can say is enclosed for the purpose, is enclosed for the purpose. Okay. So now you will say that all the details, if you will provide me at the earliest, that will be highly appreciated. So if you will say that, if you will provide all the information at the earliest will help me. What it will do? It will help me to join the course. Will help me to join the course. To join the course immediately. Okay, so you have talked just to the point. Okay, you have not, you can say, beating about the bush. What you are going to ask, you have just written that. This is inquiry letter. Okay, so that finally, because it is a formal letter, then complimentary clause, yours truly only, truly, and then your name. Right? So I hope that it is clear. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, Vanshika, your question?
Ma'am, the board is not clear.
It's to rest, though it is clear. Yes, Dia is saying it's fine. Okay, so now write down a question for you. Write down a question for you. Write down a question for you. You are, write down a question, you are Akhil, I'm writing on the board. Suppose you are Akhil of 129 Mall Road, Shimla. Okay, Mall Road, Shimla, right? And you are interested to join a short term course. You are interested to join a short term course, suppose in computer programming. In computer programming, you want to ask about a short term course in computer programming. Write a letter to Computer World, or write a letter to the head of the Computer World. So head means here the director. Okay, write a letter to the head of Computer World. I have given the name of the institution to ask about relevant details. So here they have not given to inquire about, they have asked you to ask about. It means that it is an inquiry letter. You will read the question and you have to understand the nature of the question too. Yes. So I hope that this is clear. Right? Okay. So another one example that we are going to do is, suppose you are given the duty to take your one or two classes for a trip. Okay. So then for that purpose, what kind of inquiry you will make? Okay. Right? Suppose you have to ask for any tour. Okay. Inquiry about tour. Okay. Suppose for that, just write down the question on the next page. Then we will write down. Yes. You are given the responsibility to take certain classes for a tour to, suppose, to a historical place. You want to inquire about certain details regarding this trip. Write a letter to any name you can suggest for tour and travels, for example, to Dream World Tours and Travels, to ask about all the details. So one we have done for course, and now next we are going for, suppose you want to take a tour. Okay, so what you will write down. Okay, so next I will hurriedly come to that point only. Sender's address, date, what will be the receiver's address here in this case?
The manager.
Dream World Tours and Travels. Okay, the director, Dream World Tours and Travels. Okay, so next afterwards, subject, to inquire about the details for a trip to a historical place. Okay, right? Okay, so next, for here to you have not seen any advertisement, okay? Or you know that this is the best company, this is the reason why you are going to ask them, okay? So first para, how you will start, para one, which is your main para, how you will start, you will start writing. For example, you are a renowned name in the field of tours and travels. You are a renowned name in the field of tours and travels. And who you are, why you are going to write, okay? And I, as an activity in charge or whatever you want to write down, is going to organize a trip for the students. You can mention of classes, suppose 6th to 10th to a historical place. You won't write here, you will mention the place where you want to go, okay? To Agra, to Delhi and Agra, okay? And for that, I want to know or I want to inquire about certain details. So this is your first para, right? That you are a renowned name in the field of tour and travels, and I, as an activity in charge, has given the responsibility to organize a tour for the students of class 6 to 10. You will mention the age group also, okay? 6 to 10 to Delhi and Agra. And for that purpose, I want to know about certain details, okay? So next, what details? Para 2, always ask about details. Ask about details. I would like to know which details first of all. So, okay? Number of days to be visited, okay? Or you can also give that as we have planned the trip for only 4 to 5 days, okay? You can mention it in this manner, as we have planned the trip for 4 to 5 days, so we would like to inquire about, okay? Give them the days, okay? So charges per head, you will ask what will be the charges per head. Then you will ask about
Mode of travel.
Then, yes.
Accommodation.
Very good. Where you will be accommodated then?
Fee structure.
That we have asked about charges.
The meals that will be included in the package.
What?
The meals that would be included in the package.
Okay.
Ma'am, check-in and check-out timings.
No, we won't ask. Meals to be included. Okay. Then, various places.
Tour services.
Then, okay.
Ma'am, availability
of guide. Right. Okay, so let us write down. Okay. So we would like to know about the charges per head and what will be the mode of travel. Okay. What will be the mode of travel for the students? And we prefer a comfortable and first class arrangement for the students. Okay, you will mention your preferences also side by side. And also I would like to know about the accommodation to be arranged for the students, whether it will be 3-star or 5-star, right? And what will be the meals to be included in the accommodation or along with the accommodation, okay? And also let me know about the various places to be visited. And is there any availability of guide? Okay, is there any availability of guide? And also, you would also like to know, and the number of teachers to accompany. Okay, because suppose if 10 students, it is the rule that for 20 students, one teacher can go, right? So in this manner, you can write down. Okay, so right? Okay. So after that, you will finish it. Okay. So now the time of the class is over. We will continue with the last paragraph tomorrow. Okay. So have a nice day to you all. So enjoy your day.